Hey everyone, greetings and blessings. Welcome, Shavua Tov. This is the beautiful north of Israel and Tzfat, mystical city, capital of Kabbalah, and which we have the merit to live in and to teach. Thank God, virtually, right, online and in person over here. And a question which I often get is, okay, there's Kabbalah and Madonna and all that pop stuff. And there's such a bad connotation with Kabbalah in general. And it's something that I'd like to a little bit speak about today. So feel free to ask your questions if you'd like. Leave them in the messages below. And so as follows, what is kosher Kabbalah essentially? So kosher Kabbalah really has to do with a number of prerequisites. First prerequisite is that the one who is learning actually is learning from a reliable source. So like anything, there is a lineage to the study of any subject in general, and especially something which is as sensitive and so exact as the study of Kabbalah. And so having the lineage and having the idea of there is a background to things, and it's not just about making ideas up, and it's not a spiritual new age concepts where we just get to innovate and to add whatever ideas that we feel and mix them in the bunch. So that's not the case. So I'd like to perhaps address that idea, because and I think people have a misconception about what this means, that why Kabbalah is sometimes coined up with all the new age stuff with magic and all those things. And so there are a number of schools of Kabbalah. And hey, Asher, there's a number of schools of Kabbalah. And when we talk about those schools of Kabbalah, so generally speaking, there are two schools. There's one school that is from the school of the Ari, and that is Sfiradic Kabbalah. And that has to do with, really, and it goes back in time, and it goes back to the Ramban, and it has to do with connecting to godliness via this medium or the channels that he put in place, which are the sfirot, which are the emanations, which I'll speak about more at the end. And then there's another school of Kabbalah, which is called Kabbalah Ma'asit. Literally speaking, it means practical Kabbalah or action level Kabbalah. And what it is essentially, it's delving into the mysteries of the universe. And as it says in the Book of Formation, that it says over there, written by Abraham, it says that the world was created by God who chakak, that he actually engraved himself into existence, chatzav v'tziref, and the word tziref means to put together. And according to Kabbalah Ma'asit, everything is interconnected, and we're able to interconnect words. And so, for example, Rabbi Avram Abulafia, who was a great Kabbalist, put together his main, path of Kabbalah was essentially the tziruf, and putting together all these tzirufim, and by understanding these permutations, essentially mathematical permutations, we're able to understand the mysteries of the universe. Now, in order to be on that level, that Rabbi Abram Abulafia and the Shari Ora, who was the student, and many others, etc., the Arizal actually quotes him, one has to be on a very holy level. And one has to be on, just like learning sequentially. We spoke about before having a lineage. There's also a sequential level of understanding. It's not enough just to say, oh, I want to understand how to magically, you know, transport myself, or I want to get to a level where I could spiritually get to this level or that level. That may be an interesting goal to reach, yes, and that's questionable in and of itself if that's the end to reach in and of itself. However, one has to understand that it has to go in levels. And we have to go level after level after level. So the problem arises, and just by the way, on that, the Rashba, Rabbi Shlomo Ben Aderet, who was living at the time over there in Barcelona, was actually vehemently against Rabbi Abu Lafia's way. And he wrote against him in a major way because he felt that that style, that way, was not the way for the masses. And so that gets us to where the impractical and what I call charlatans of Kabbalah really come in, and they try to hijack this whole system that is really a holy system and try to utilize it for their own good and say, hey, you want to know how to transport yourself? You want to know how to reach this high mystical level you could create? By the way, the students of Rabbi Avraham Abu Lafia had in their manuscripts how to create what is called a golem, which is how to take an inanimate object and give life to it. So major things were going on in those books. So do you want to learn how to make a golem? Go right ahead, study this. The thing is, in our generation, my friends, it's not really possible. We're not really able to reach that. And those people that will tell you that you're able to reach that are absolutely charlatans, and they're using what is called Kabbalah in order to hijack and in order to kidnap people who are a bit naive and impractical in their inner world. Which brings me to the second and main idea over here that I'd like to really impart, and that's something that I teach, and that's something that I believe is practical for us, is utilizing the lessons of Kabbalah, how to essentially better our lives in every single day, which is something that we should all really want, because we know that there's IQ, and then there's EQ, and there's spiritual Q. So I think that a lot of people that are involved in Kabbalah have no EQ and no real spiritual IQ. And what I mean by that, and I know that may sound like a bit harsh, but IQ means you could have intelligence, you could understand concepts, but it's not about understanding concepts. It's incorporating them into one's being. Where Rabbi Chaim Vital says that the whole essence of the learning of Torah in general, and Kabbalah in particular, is impossible without first having a kli, without first having a vessel. And that vessel over there is the vessel of good character traits. And I repeat myself, good character traits. And that may seem like odd, like what? Good character traits? You should know how to go across, you know, fly across there, you know, do all that mystical stuff. No. It all starts with good character traits. So if you happen to see someone who is quote unquote a mystic or a teacher and does not have a good character trait, then you could be sure that whatever they're learning is not the real deal. And they may have IQ, but they do not have the application. They do not have the EQ, which is what Kabbalah is really supposed to bring one to. Supposed to bring one to a bettering, to an improving of one's characteristic traits and the communication skills, getting along with others, speaking in a positive way, and learning just the practical skills of how to be a decent, first starting decent human being. Like it says, Derech Eretz, having good traits, Kadma la Torah. So before jumping onto the bandwagon of knowing all these secret things, the first thing is utilizing what we need to do in how to have a fixed communication and how to have fixed a good way about us. And so in this week's Haftarah Torah portion, at the end of it, it says by Malachi, the angel, Navi, Malachi says at the end over there, he says that one should choose a teacher. What's a teacher? Like a malach tzvakot. He's like an angel of God. And it says that the lips of a Kohen will safeguard da'at, will safeguard understanding. And Torah they should ask from his mouth. So the Talmud says that if the teacher is a angel of God, then you should ask Torah from his mouth. But if he's not an angel of God, don't ask from his mouth. So people ask, so commentaries ask on that, what does that mean? We don't know what an angel of God is. How could you know if your teacher is an angel of God? And the answer is, what is the defining characteristic of angels? The characteristic defining of angels is that they're able to get along with each other. They're able to get along with each other. And so when one path or teacher tells you that this is the way, we have the only path, which is a danger in some schools, and I'm not gonna name them out, that they say that we have the path, we have the only truth, and everyone else does not have it. Everyone else does not know what's up. So that's not an angel of God, because they're essentially saying, we are the chosen ones. We are the ones that have the school of how to do things. Nobody else knows what to do. That's not an angel of God. So from that type of school and from that type of an individual, one should stay very far away from, because they're essentially utilizing what they know in order to, I'm just going to say, basically brainwash and basically bring people in to their cult and into their way of thinking. And that's a very dangerous place to be in. Because as I said before, the whole essence of learning in general, learning Kabbalah and learning Torah in general, is to better our characteristic traits. And the opposite of being brainwashed, it's actually being self-empowered, having the intelligence and having the EQ and the spiritual IQ to be able to know how to live our life on the highest level. So anyone that says we have the path, the only path, they're not an angel of God, and one should stay very far away from. Anyways, those are my thoughts for now on kosher versus unkosher Kabbalah. Food for thought for you guys. I'd like to actually share with you regarding the spherotic approach, something that I've been working on for many months now in our online school, livekabbalah.com. We put together the Sphera package, which I culled from over 12 classes and PDF notes, which we're working on actually to become a book, and amazing content over there, which I'd like to share with you, and I'm opening it up now for everyone to get a glimpse actually of what the Sphirot are really all about. And again, I'm not coming out saying that this is the only way, again, but I feel that after years of learning and having a rabbinical ordination and teaching over here for many years, not just in Tzfat, but abroad and in Florida, etc., that I've come to the point that I feel very confident, and I feel that this is really what's needed out there, is a healthy approach to the understanding of the basics of Kabbalah. And that's why we're going to be releasing these 10 Sphirot package course, which we're going to share with you below. And so please, love to hear your comments. Check out that package course. Let me know what you think, and please share this video around. I feel it's an important idea that really needs to get around and circulated, and so that people have just a more informed idea of what Kabbalah is and what Kabbalah could be and what it's supposed to be. So with that, I'm gonna wish you guys a Shavua Tov, a good week, a Chodesh Tov, a good month. From here, the beautiful city of Tzfat. and let me know what you think, and many blessings. So may we all have an amazing, beautiful week ahead of us. See ya.